think it's better sometimes the coach do this more often to try to put the pieces in on the place. So when we arrived here, as you know, the expectations is very not big expectations, normal expectations. We achieve a playoff in the first season, a fantastic season. Play underdogs, like all the seasons are one team that play underdogs. Last season was Huddersfield, this season Bristol also was doing really very well. And we achieved a sixth place, but in that moment I have here the facts. We have we achieved with 19 points from Burnley that promoted in that time. So there are a big gap between what we achieve and the first places. But we are fighting with more teams to try to go to the playoffs. And some of them up than us and down than us, they was near to achieve this situation. Second year, we know that the expectations will be more high in this moment. We knew about that, but we take a risk to go to continue the work to try to do better and do better. We did a season with one or another problem. So during the season, around January, February, March, we came a little down. We start losing some games and we draw some of them in this period. And it was a period that we felt a little also some stabilization around the team because we miss in that moment some games and some points. But something happened in that moment. I have here my numbers. We lose in that moment Hooper, Kieran Lee, Abdi, Fletcher, Sam, Tom, Forestieri, Bannon was playing with a pain, but he was playing. And we lose these players and we come a little down. But after, when we recover the players, we go again. And in this moment, gave them image, we talk about that the team in that moment play different and play more solid, more defensive. And of course, did that. I explained after in the beginning of this season, because we don't have the same players, so we must protect ourselves. We must achieve points like we achieved the points to after achieve the playoff, winning six games on the row when we recover the players. And we achieve the fourth place very strong in that moment. But even this, we achieve 13 points to Newcastle and 12 to Brighton. So still some gap, and we achieve with fourth place, but Huddersfield with same points, Fulham 1 point, Leeds not far, Norwich not far, Derby not far away from us. So we achieve that situation. Competing with another teams, even we achieve a fourth place. So third season, we are talking about this season, expectations more high, we understand that. Let's try to do better than the previous season or the previous season. So better than previous season is better than fourth place, even we was fighting with another teams. We know that when we accept to continue the work, we know the risks that we'll take in this season because the expectations is very high. Then other teams have more value. The championship is more balanced in this moment. They are all the time like Wolves did, for example, good investments, and they are putting the teams better and better. But even we have opportunity to move in these 2 years one or two times also here to the Premier. We decided to stay because we like the club, we like the fans, we like the players, we have emotional connection. Even is a big risk, we know, to the third season, we decided to stay because we believe in our work. Believing in our work, we need something very important that I think is crucial to everybody, that even we are under the financial fair play and we don't have too much money to bring players, we knew that also, is something that we knew. But if we don't have this, what you need basic things like put everybody improving, individual and collective, and try also to do better than the past, winning more games, of course, don't take it too many goals, try to score more goals and try to improve the team. This was our challenge. But the things must be, in my opinion, must be normal in this run. In this normal must be To achieve that, the players fit, all the players competing to a place in the team, important players on the squad, everybody fit and everybody ready, internal competition very high, to try to put the team with high intensity and play in the level that we play the first and second year. The reality is a little different. Because I try to collect the pieces because sometimes I think it's better to do that. The reality is that facts, and I will repeat again, but just because I'm doing a resume, this gap, because I think we are two steps down that we expect. One of the step in the reality was that bad decisions make us lose in the minimum 10 points that can put us in different situation. And addicted to this, we are playing with important players out of the team in this moment, and that the players that can bring us some of them that we don't have really a substitute to them in the abilities that they have. And there is not one or two. We are talking about a lot of players. We are talking about Jack Kent, Tom Lees, George Boyd, Sam Hutchinson, Kieran Lee, Fernando Forestieri, Fletcher. So we are talking about seven important players, and all of them they are important, that can make us absolutely sure, even we trust in all the players, and we trust in all the players, of course, make us with more internal competition, and some of them is the base of this team in these 2 years and a half, and also make, when two or three don't play, make change the face of the team and in the levels of aggressive, in the levels of the pressure the opponents, press the opponents, in the way that we can also to be more near the goal. They are very important to achieve this kind of performance and the level of this kind of performance. So make us this situation stay in the position that we have so far. You can discuss if it's the fault of the coach, if it's the f sure that is not fault of the chairman, because the chairman is doing absolutely fantastic. He's a fantastic chairman. He's doing absolutely everything what he can do. After we can discuss a lot of things, if it's the coach, if it's the injuries, if it's the about this and this and this. But I live with the reality. This is my explanation to the position that we have in this moment. We don't change the philosophy, we don't change absolutely the ideas. We lived this in the past, in the last year, especially in the last year, and we drop. And in that moment, I remember that was the environment was not so good also because we start losing points. But when we recover players, we stay more competitive and we win the last 6 matches and we achieve the playoffs. In this moment, we dropped more. Because these 10 points or 12 points that I talked before will put us, even with these kind of problems, will put us in our natural position, so 6, 7, 5, 8 in this moment, not doing great, but doing our level. This is the reality. And I start to talk about this because I will not answer absolutely nothing about my personal situation because I explain my point of view. After you can explain or you can conclude what you want about that situations. I just want to tell you that I feel absolutely confident in the work that we are doing. I'm not changed the philosophy. We don't change too much the players. We lose players. This is a reality. Important players, and we are trying to do all the days working hard and work really hard to try to move the things. I try to put the things in the correct place, like we did in the last year when we drop, when we lose. I remember, for example, between the 32 game and 38, we lose 4 games, we draw 2, and we win just 1 victory in this period. So it was a bad period to us, and I remember this period. But we're still working, we still blame the players, we recover the players, we win 6 on a row, and we achieve the playoffs. So this is my explanation and my resume what we did in the last 2 years and a half. And after this, I don't have nothing to addicted more than talk about the game tomorrow, if you don't mind, because I don't have nothing to addicted after this.
From what you've just delivered there, what amongst all of that prevents you from playing the kind of creative, attacking, ambitious football that we saw from Carlos Cavalli, Sheffield Wednesday in the first season that you were here?
Listen, do you think that Forestieri, Sam Hutchinson, Kieran Lee, the kind of abilities about high intensity, pressing the opponents, will not make impact if they play or not play in the face of the team? I'm not talking that it's better or worse, but in the high intensity, in the tempo, in the pressing, if they are on the pitch, is one thing. If they are not on the pitch, the face of the team is completely different. It's normal.
Are the players coming into the team just not good enough then?
I don't say that. They are different abilities, but don't expect that one player play exactly the same than another player. So don't expect this, because it's not real. And you know that. You know that one player is one thing, another player is completely different. Change the face of the team, of course. And we are happy with all the players, but there are players that you don't have a really substitute to them in the squad. So take Messi from Barcelona, will substitute Messi in Barcelona. Who? We don't have substitute to Messi. Take Busquets to the team, you don't have a substitute. Even in Barcelona, you don't have a substitute to Busquets in the team. You have another player that can play there, but it's not the same level. It's a different player. With a good abilities, maybe they will pass well the ball, but a level of high intensities, they are completely different. I'm not talking about that. I'm not happy with the players that we have, but in the reality, there are some players that you can't be with two players like that on the squads. So I wish, but I can't be with two Forestieris, two Sam Hutchinson, two Kieran Lees on the squad, because you must spend probably 12 or 15 million each.
Would it be fair to assert that, given that you've begun this press conference essentially justifying the job that's happened at Sheffield Wednesday, that you feel more threat?
No, absolutely. I'm just try to collect a resume, because I don't read the things. But yesterday I was talking with some journalists, because we have a meeting, informal meeting, and I stay surprised how sometimes the things are not collected at the hand, because I suppose that when we analyze something, we don't analyze just the last game and last performance, but to analyze deep everything, and someone must analyze deep everything and why the things happen. It's not just because the things is like this. So let's try to understand why the things happen, why these are happening. We are more strong in this moment than we was 1 year ago. In this moment, we are, or we are not, I don't know, I'm asking. This is questions that we must put also on the table to try to analyze something. Is why I try to do, to try to analyze the 2 years and a half with facts. I'm not try to create a subjective thing or things that is not a reality. I'm talking about facts, about concrete things, about the position, the points, the injury players. And these kind of things make impact. So these kind of things, this thing happened in last year with us. I remember that the questions last season was similar this season. I remember, I have a good memory. And after, when I said that we are in this position, but we need to recover players, not just we don't believe in the players that we have, but they give more tempo, they give more intensity. Also, with that players, we have more internal fight. And in the reality, maybe 2 or 3 weeks when we recover the players, we start winning games. I remember this. You can, maybe you have registered what I said 1 year ago, or in this period, you will say that I said that. And these kind of things happen when we recover the players. So I'm not lying, or I'm not, it was a reality. In this moment, I'm feeling the same problems, I think more problems, comparing with in the period that we needed absolutely sure to achieve what we want, everybody fit, everybody progressing, everybody better, individual and collective. We need also that, as I told, the decisions don't make. Imagine that the decision was in the opposite side. So instead we lose 10 points, we win 3. So we have this 10 more 3, and the things will be different. But everything together make the work more difficult. It's something that we must manage, but is not easy to manage these kind of things. And we are trying to do our best, me and my players, to try to win games. So we did very honest work last week. We work hard to prepare the game against Norwich. We start very well the game, something that we didn't start before, and we start very well. We did a very good first half, and after the second half we lose something in the game. We lose the game, but this week we are preparing the game tomorrow the best that we can, understanding that we'll play tomorrow against the best team that I saw in Championship in these 2 seasons and a half. I think is the best team, not just because they have individual, but also because they have collective. They have individual very good players, And also they have a good organization, make them, in my opinion, the best team that I saw in championship in the last 2 years and a half. So tomorrow we have a big challenge with the game tomorrow.
From your perspective, how do you feel the fans feel about this team and you at the moment?
Listen, I try to explain my point of view. So if the people that are hearing me understand what I'm talking, probably there are a lot of people that will understand that. Some people more emotional will not understand that. But I can do more than try to explain what happened with the reasonable things and what happened. I can do about explanations more than this. So I will be not inside to talk about this or this, because this is what we try to win in games. I try to prepare the team, but I think it's important, is why I do this resume, to try to understand deep everything, because it's not just the last game or two games, but understand in general everything.
I want to ask you two specific things about the team at the moment. Do you think you've got enough physicality in midfield when you don't have Sam Hutchinson in there? And if you haven't, why do you think that is? Why can't the players that you've got at your disposal provide that?
Jonah and Bannon, they are different players. Bannon is a player, as you know, when Kieran and Sam play, Bannon play a lot in the left side with us, if you remember, because he's a player that is a fantastic player, he's an unbelievable player. But when you have two strong players like Sam and Kieran in the past, we prefer to put him on the left to try to control the game with the ball from the left. When he play in the center, still a good player to move the ball. He's not a physical that player that the people, of course, because when I said physical, about the body, but he's a player that do very well the job in and Jonas. When you have these kind of players, you need also that in front of you, you have more capacity to press the opponents, because if you have in front of them more capacity to press the opponents, these kind of players, they will be probably more up on the pitch. If you don't press too much in the attack, if you don't have players that is that really strong players to press more in the attack, these kind of players, natural, they drop a little more and they come more to with the lines more down, because they protect a little themselves. It's what happens sometimes in our team, happened in the last games. So we start pressing very well 45 minutes. We decrease the pressing in the attack a little in the second half. It's not the problem of the defense of the midfield. We start not pressing too much in the attack. So the midfielders, they start to control the game in the middle. They must drop a little and look like they are more weak than really they are. They are not weak. But these kind of things make an impact in the game, and we lose a little the control of the game in the middle, not in the middle of midfield, but we start losing a little the control in the attack, because we don't press like we want and we wish. We decrease a little.
At the start of the year, we asked whether or not there was enough pace in the team, and you answered that then, but is that something that you badly need? You know, when January comes around, is that going to be one of the absolute top priorities for this club, to at least get one or two players even who can run at people, who can take people on and have got pure pace?
I agree. But listen, we talk more about this because we don't have Forestieri. Because Forestieri have pace and he's aggressive to win in the ball. So we have... he achieve more balls on the back of the defenders. He is the first player that start defending in the team very strong and winning balls in the attack. So when he don't play, you feel more this. Because if he's 100% fit, we'll not talk about pace, believe me, because we don't talk about pace in the first year and second year too, like we are in second season more, because he was injury the last 10 games or something. He was playing 10 minutes, 15. We tried to manage him in the best way, if you remember. But when he play, is completely different. But you can say to me, but we don't have Forestieri, we can achieve a different player also to with pace and so on. And the problem that first we don't expect that will be injury, and second, to achieve a player with the abilities of Forestieri, we must spend 10 or 15 millions, and you are under the financial fair play, and we can't do that. So with the injury of him, make emergency in that moment. Exactly, if you remember, he was to the surgery maybe 3 or 4 days after the close the transfer window. If you ask me, if you, it was the surgery 1 day before the transfer window, if we need a player with pace and with some skills, absolutely, I will try to achieve one. But it was injury after the close the transfer window.
Have your team been guilty at times this year of maybe playing too safe? Have they taken enough risks? And is that something that you want to see more from them?
We don't training to do that, but in the reality, it's the same like last season, if you remember. In that period that I'm talking, when we miss some players, we must be clever to play, because you can play the same way. Because if you can play the same way, we lose 3 or 4-0. And sometimes, when you have the players, we must look at the players that we have. I talk about the John and Baz in the middle, and I talk the importance of the attackers to press the opponents, to that feel more strong and to press them, to press also. But if you don't put the players, or if the players have this kind of weakness sometimes, one or moment of the game, the team instinctive, I told you, protect themselves. It's not because I said you must play like this, they protect themselves. I don't know if you understand what I mean. So if you don't press too much up, if you start losing capacity to press the opponents nowadays, they don't play like before in championship. Before in championship, they play long balls. Now you must manage in different way the football. Our attackers must be very strong to stop the opponents, the defenders to start to play, and also the central midfielders and so on, because everything starts there. So it's different, the role. The role of the attackers must be, they must be very, very strong to stop the beginning of the attackers. If you are not strong enough, they start to play from the back, and they go inside our team. And when the team go inside of you, looking to you, so you have the line of four, the attackers are out, and I go to you, what you do? Because they come with the ball, you don't go to them to press the ball, you instinctive, you come down, you understand? You start to protect them more, because you don't want to take goals. It's instinctive, you understand? It's not, maybe you said that, but if you play another players with different abilities, can be different, Sam or Kiram in this case, because they are not better or not, because they are different abilities, when they broke the first line, they will immediately jump and they will try to block you more in front. Because it's the abilities that they have, they go, so you are more strong there in defensive part, even we are weak here, but the team is still strong. But when you are, sometimes you are not strong here in defensive part of the job, and they have this kind of abilities, they come a little more down. It's not, don't make them worse players or better, you understand? But it's the abilities of the players.
Do you ever think, though, that, you know, no wins in five, just 2 wins in 10, you know, what have you got to lose now? You know, if you're is maybe risking conceding an extra goal or two against Wolves on Friday, for example, is it worth it to try and go out there and win that game, attack Wolves and get a much-needed 3 points?
We'll try to do, we prepare the game like, we prepared the game very well against Norwich again. So because if we don't prepare very well the game, we'll not do the first half that, like we did. So we prepared, we did everything. But after we didn't do 90 minutes what we must do. We start falling one or another thing. We'll do the same against Wolves. We prepared the game. I believe that we prepared the game very well. We know exactly how they play. We know exactly what the main points of the team, that they have a lot of strong points. This team have a lot of strong points, very, very few weak points. But the weak points that they have, we must try to explore the maximum. We prepare, we don't prepare the game, any game so far, to try to don't win. We all the time we try to win, and we will do the same next game with the players that we have at the moment, give confidence to them. And let's try to win the game. If you ask me if I wish to play this kind of game with these players, more than 7 players, and let's see if it's not more, 7 players that are out to choose the first 11, I prefer choose with more addicted, these players that I have with more 7, of course, I prefer. But the reality is not like that. And one thing very important, maybe the people will say, oh, but you have a lot of injuries, is the fault of the methodology. It's not. Forestieri knee, Boyd shoulders, Jack Kent knee, Tom Lee's degenerative tendon, Kieran Lee the hips again, Forrest had a talk already, Fletcher the knee also. So we don't have also muscle problems that can happen one on another, but it's not the problem. It's knees, hips, the shoulders, is something that is not in our control, what I try to pretend you. Sorry.
I know you said at the start you don't want to talk about your position or anything, but as far as you're concerned, will you be in charge of Sheffield Wednesday, whatever happens in this game on Friday? Are you here for the rest of the season?
It's not decisive, no. I hear that someone write about that, because last game I said that we must win Friday. But immediately I said, like we must win after against Middlesbrough, like we must win against Norwich, because we must start winning games. So, but I think they put the things that I said, that I must win Friday, if not something will happen. So it's why someone I think write about that, but it's not fair, because I explained my sentence in that moment.
You're going to be here for the long term then, whatever happens in
this game. I believe that we'll be at the end, and I believe that we'll go to the Premier. I still believe in that. But I must recover the players. I must put everybody. So not me, but we must put all the players fit, understanding that when we are back with Jack, with Tom, with Boyd, with Kieran Lee, with Sam, with Fletcher, with Forestieri, we'll be more strong. Absolutely sure. Absolutely sure.
You mentioned the injuries, though.
It's almost a team. It's almost 11.
Just a quick question on the injuries. Fernando Forestieri's been on social media again. He's put a video on of him. I think he's training currently in Rome. Is it usual for players to recover from an injury and do training, you know, away from the facility? I mean, why isn't he here doing this work?
No, but he's not doing training. It's a recover. It's in the recover. In this moment, he's in the process about recover on the physio room and. And outside is in this process. When we'll be fit and ready to training to the team, the first day that we'll be ready, we'll come back. And we expect that we'll be back in January if nothing wrong will happen wrong with him. If you ask me, is normal or not normal? Is not nothing that a lot of players and in different clubs, also in the big clubs, sometimes the players do. They have a big confidence in some doctors. They want to be near them because they have confidence from the past in different things, and they request to be ready near the. Not just the people that they trust, but people that really are good also, because we have a very good physio department, but they are with abilities and they're people that they trust. So and we know that he's working hard because he's a fighter, and I believe that we'll be back to training with the team in January. I believe that.
When players do that, is it easy for the club to keep up to date with how they're progressing and whether everything's okay and whether, you know, they're having the kind of treatment that you want them to have, essentially?
No, we know all the weekly we have the a report about the situation of the player, and 2 and 2 months we have the report also the doctor that do the surgery. He was in Rome with the doctor that did the surgery. I received the report. Everything is in good way. No problems so far about the recover. He can recover faster than normal. Normally 6-8 months, but we believe that he can recover in 4 months. And so far, I don't want to put too much pressure, but he's in good way. He's in good way.
Just to finish, what is the single most important thing for you to try and get a result on this game on Friday against a really good Wolves team?
We must be play with a big heart and with a big commitment, and also we must put in our head that we can win the game. This is the most important. We can win the game and be very very concentrated about the opponent, because they have some players that don't belong to Championship, some players that they are really top level. Two of them, I like them a lot, even when they play national team, like Ruben Neves and Diogo Jota, and the others are really, really good. But against these situations and the problems that we have in this moment, we just have a formula. a big commitment, a big heart, and let's fight to the game, and let's try also to put the fans in our side to try to do a good result.